Let's take a look at how the primary contact on a donation is specified and how soft credit is given for donations from individuals and organizations. When we receive a donation, we want to make sure that the right person or organization gets hard credit, which means the gift came directly from them. We also want the right people or organizations to get soft credit because they played a role in securing the donation or have a relationship with the donor. The assignment of hard and soft credit works a bit differently depending on whether it's a personal gift or a gift from an organization. Let's look first at a gift from an individual. We receive a donation from our longtime supporter, John Burks, in the form of a check from his personal bank account. We created the opportunity from John's contact record. John automatically gets an opportunity contact role of donor, which will roll up to John's contact record as a hard credit. The other members of John's household will automatically get a contact role of household member for soft credit, which is the default setting in NPSP. Soft credit can also be given to a gift's honoree contact or notification recipient when the gift is given in honor or in memory of someone. The contact roles on relationship records can automatically give a person soft credit for an individual gift. We can configure different kinds of contact roles, assign them to different people on a donation record, automatically or manually, and then have those donations roll up as different kinds of soft credit to the contact records using customizable rollups. So what if a contact is eligible for more than one contact role for an individual gift? How does NPSP choose? NPSP will create the contact role first based on whether the person is the primary contact. Next, it will assign the contact role based on the person being the honoree contact. After that, on their being the notification recipient. Next, on whether they have a relationship record with a related contact role specified. And finally, it will give the contact role based on membership in the same household account. Now, let's look at how gifts from organizations are different. Let's enter a gift from the Shaw Family Foundation. Because this is an organization gift, the primary contact will not automatically be filled in. We can fill in Lisa Shaw, our primary contact, manually as we create the opportunity, and when we save, a contact role will be created for Lisa based on the NPSP settings. If we prefer to automatically record a contact role for Lisa on every opportunity from the Shaw Family Foundation, so we don't forget or if it is different from the primary contact role, we can assign a related contact role on her affiliation record. What if a contact is eligible for multiple types of automatic soft credit on organization gifts? How does NPSP choose? For organization gifts, NPSP will apply the contact role first based on whether the person is the primary contact. If they're not the primary contact, NPSP will then look to see if they are the honoree contact, then notification recipient, and finally, it will give the contact role specified on an affiliation record between the organization account and the contact. Whenever we save a gift, we always review the contact roles related list to make sure everyone has been given the correct contact role. We can make any needed changes manually. Remember that soft credit rollups are only recalculated overnight, but we can recalculate Lisa's soft credit right away by clicking the Recalculate Rollups button on her contact record. To recalculate all rollups, we can run the Rollup Donations Batch bulk data process in NPSP settings. Configuring contact roles and rollups allows us to give our supporters the credit they deserve. For more details and best practices, see the NPSP documentation. Thanks for watching.